Hello everyone, today we will tear down the HyperJuice Stackable 100W charger. We can see the product and its name are printed on the front side, and the back side had some features. Open the box and take out the charger. The front side comes with a small AC port, which is the US standard, and can support up to 1500W. We can stack up to 15 same model chargers, bringing total output power of up to 1600W. The specification on the back shows the model is HJ417. It supports wide range input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 2.4 amp. In terms of output, 3 USB-C can support 100 watts and the USB-A can support 18 watts. It also passed FCC certification. Those four ports are decorated with orange rings and the inside is also orange and foldable pins. We can see the width is 45.19mm, thickness is 13.82mm, and the length is 84.85mm. Weight is 162.9 grams. Using ChargerLab Power ZKT002 to test the USB-C one, which supports Apple 2.4 amp, Samsung 5 volts 2 amp, DCP protocol, and QC2, QC3, AFC, FCP, PE2, PD3, PPS fast charging protocols. It also supports 5 fixed PDOs of 5 volts, 3 amp, 9 volts, 3 amp, 12 volts, 3 amp, 15 volts, 3 amp, 20 volts, 5 amp, and 1 PPS PDO of 3.3 to 21 volts, 3 amp. And the USB-C2 and USB-3 have the same specifications, and USB-A supports SCP protocol additionally. Then let's tear it down. Remove the shell and take out the internal module. The AC pin is fixed together with the module. The back of the PCB is covered with a brass heatsink. Remove it. The front of the PCB is bounded by a transformer. The input end is the rectifier and filtering circuit, and the output end is the secondary step-down circuit. Since the primary control circuit is independent, there are not too many chips on the backside. And there is the synchronous rectifier circuit on the secondary circuit. There is a 5A time delay fuse on the small PCB at the input end. The common mode choke is used to filter out EMI interference. The safety X capacitor comes from KNSCHA. It adopts multiple capacitors from different brands. This one comes from Yongming's KCX series, 400 volts, 27 microfarad. The other one comes from Yuguang, 400 volts, 12 microfarad. The rest of 5 capacitors comes from KNSCHA. 3 of them are 400 volts, 33 microfarad, and 2 of them are 400 volts, 22 microfarad. The capacitor of master control chip is also from KNSCHA, 50 volts, 10 microfarad. The master control chip and GaN chip are soldered on the small PCB next to the transformer, which comes from ON Semiconductor, NCP1342. It is a high-frequency quasi-resonant flyback primary PWM controller with an integrated active X2 capacitor discharge feature. The GaN FET comes from Navitas NV6127 and packaged by QFN6×8mm. It can support up to 2 MHz switching frequency and the heat dissipation performance has been improved. And the resistance is 125 milliohm. There are some resistance and capacitors on the back of the PCB. There are 2 rectifier bridges on the back of the main PCB, which are connected in parallel to dissipate the heat. The SMD Y capacitor between the primary and the secondary circuit comes from TRX. The small size and lightweight are very suitable for high-density power products such as GaN fast charging. The chip on the secondary circuit is a synchronous rectifier controller, which comes from MPS MP6908A. Maximum operating frequency is 600 kHz. Those two synchronous rectifier MOSFETs are connected in parallel. Model is AOS-AON-S62922, with standard voltage is 120 volts. The low dropout regulator is in the corner. Model is SG-Micro-SGM-2200. 3 USB-C ports are soldered on the same PCB. It adopts two independent step-down circuits with two step-down chips and two output VBUS switch MOSFET. The secondary step-down chip comes from iSmartware SW3516H, which is a highly integrated dual-port charging chip with multiple fast charging protocols. It supports independent current limiting of dual-port and integrates 5-amp high-efficiency synchronous buck converter. The circuit is also controlled by this chip. The specification of solid capacitor for output filtering is 25 volts 100 microfarad. The step-down circuit of the third USB-C port is on this PCB. The step-down chip also adopts iSmartware SW3516H. The step-down circuit of the USB-A port is on this PCB. The step-down chip adopts iSmartware SW3526, which integrated MOSFET and 3.5-amp high-efficiency synchronous buck converter. It can support output control of USB-C port or USB-A port. The output filtering capacitor of USB-A is also from Yuguang, 25 volts, 220 microfarad. All four ports are coordinated and controlled by an external single-chip microcomputer, which can intelligently distribute the power. I have to say, the HyperJuice Stackable 100W charger is based on the traditional charger and adopts an innovative design. The addition of AC socket can expand the power up to 1600 watts. It has also achieved high efficiency and small size based on GaN technology. It supports 100 watts output for any USB-C and 18 watts output for USB-A and is compatible with mainstream charging protocols. Okay, that's all for today's video. By the way, we made a special unboxing video of this charger. You can click the right corner to check it out if you're interested. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and visit our official website, chargerlab.com. See you in the next video. Bye!